Hello and welcome to Pulling the Perfect Key with me, Ben Brownlee from Boris FX. In this short tutorial series, we're going to be looking at how we can use Boris FX Primatte Studio to create a perfect key, including pulling the primary key, spill suppression, hold in and hold out masks, and then we'll look at tying the whole thing together using other effects found within the Boris Continuum package. So without any more further ado, let's take a look at our clips. Now I've got our two clips loaded into the timeline here. I've just got our green screen and our still background plate here. Okay, and because we're not going to be doing too much with any editing, I'm just going to right click in the viewer and turn this into single monitor mode. So we've got a bit more space for when we start doing the effects. I'm also going to use the effects workspace preset and just give us a little bit more space there. So in the effect palette, I'm going to take a look at the continuum, key and blend filters. Now we have quite a few to choose from, but actually the only one I'm really interested in is Primatte Studio. And I'm just going to apply that to my clip. And you'll notice that when I do that, I get this new Primatte Studio UI popping up on top of my image. And this is really useful because for a lot of this stuff, I don't even have to touch the effect editor. I do most of my work directly in the viewer here. I'm not going to go through all of these buttons from the top to the bottom. We're going to get to them as they start to become useful. So the first thing we need to do is create our primary key. So if we take a look at our clip, there are a few things that are going to make pulling this key a little bit tricky. For the first, we have an uneven green screen. This is very common. And we also have gaps in the green screen over at the side. If we take a look at our clip in a bit more detail, I'll just zoom in a little bit and we zoom up a little bit around here. And I'm using Control and Alt just to pan around. You can see that we have some fine hair detail that we want to maintain in our shot. You'll also see, actually, if I bring that around here, you'll also see we have reflections in the sword of the green screen that we're going to want to keep in as well. And, you know, there's some other stuff going on with the shield that we'll have a look at in a little bit. So all in all, there are quite a few things that are going to be a bit challenging with this shot. Now I'm going to find a frame where things are nicely in focus and where we have some good hair detail visible to us. And we're going to use this frame to pull the primary key. So the first thing I'm going to do in Primatte Studio is click on AutoAnalyse. And then the filter is going to go off and try and analyze our shot and see what background we are probably using. If it's a green screen, blue screen, something in the middle screen, and then try and pull a key off of that. And it's done an all right job for a single key push. And as I scrub this through, obviously we can start to see where we have that uneven green screen. See the folds almost there, there and there. Quite fun to look at. So we know that even though we're sort of in the right sort of area, we haven't got a usable key yet. Now I'm going to pop down to the bottom buttons on my panel and we can start to have a look at things like the primary matte or the hybrid matte, which we're not going to be using in this case, or outside masks and source. You know, we've got all these different views available just at a click of a button. Now the final matte seems like it would be a good place to go just to see the quality of our key. But we're not at that stage yet. What's going to be more useful for us is our matte status view. And this has only three colors. It has black, where our alpha channel is completely transparent. We have white, where our alpha channel is completely opaque. And we have gray, where it is neither one of those two things. So we can easily see semi-transparent pixels in our background, even though in the final matte, that's not quite as easy to see. So I've got a couple of ways of cleaning this up. And if you'll notice that our next default tool is actually clean background. So what I can do here is I can just draw on the background and that will help to clean up those colors. And because we're using our matte status mode, we can easily see when we have a few stray pixels still. Now, conversely, I can come into clean foreground and I can clean up things like the shield or any of the small areas within the face that are being keyed out at the moment. And I don't have to use a point. I can also use a rectangle and just click and draw over that shape there, just to pick up a few more stray pixels. And I pop us back into clean background and back onto point, because I'm going to change up a couple of things here as well. Now, if I play this back, you can see that we've still got quite a bit of work still to do. But this view can be a little bit deceiving. And the reason for that is our video quality. So if I pop down to the bottom here and just toggle through the different modes, we probably want to bring the processing up to full so that we can more easily see any of these stray pixels. There we go. Now I'll just quickly scrub through just to see if there are any big areas that kind of come into view. And that's not looking bad. All right. As you can, you know, easily tell, it's not perfect, but if we take a look at the final mat, you can see we've done what we set out to do in this section. We're keeping in a lot of the fine detail. Now if I play this through on a loop, you can actually see that within just a few seconds, we've pulled quite a good, convincing key. We've got a lot of nice fine hair details, especially at the top. We've not got any big spots within our image either. And overall, I'm very happy with where we are at this stage of the process. As you can see, we've still got some reflections going on in the sword that we have to sort out later. And we still have the mess going on either side. I'm not worried about that at all right now. So if I take a look at our final composite, even here you can see we're not in too bad of a position. So in this section, we quickly analyze the video and we've pulled our primary key. The next section is going to be all about spill suppression. So we're going to take a look at what we can do to remove any of the green spill that's happening in the hair and around the body, so that our footage doesn't scream out that it originated on a green screen. My name is Ben Brownlee from Boris FX, and join me in part two of pulling the perfect key in Avid. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions or comments about Primatte Studio or any of the other things that you've seen in this video, then please leave them below. To find out the latest news about Primatte Studio, Continuum, and all of the Boris FX products, join us over at borisfx.com.